President, good to see you.
Good to see you.
Maxine Turan.
Hello there.
Lord Gillis.
Hello, sir.
Bringing up the rear is my daughter Susan. Republican National Committee, I'm sure you're aware of that.
I think so.
Sometime back, you were kind enough to sign a resolution on Children's Liver Disease Awareness Week. This young woman lost her daughter 9 years ago, and she is now head of the Children's Liver Foundation. And this young woman has been all district that she has in New York. Who may lose a life unless we are able to find a donor. You were immensely helpful in your radio appeal, and we've received well over 5,000 donors, and probably much more than that today as a result of what you did. They are here to thank you, and they're excited, they're nervous, and but they're beautiful people, and they're doing great work, Mr. President. I appreciate your giving us this time. Why don't you say hello?
Yes, and Mr. President, we'd like you to accept this on behalf of all the work that you've done to help our cause, and I know we can count on you in the future as a supporter, and thank you very much.
Well,
thank you.
Come on, Lord, you're in dialogue with kids too. Come on.
Well, I think it's absolutely wonderful, sir, and on behalf of my daughter and thousands of other children like her across the country, you're giving them an opportunity at life, a chance at life, and it's very important to them and to us, because you're in a position to make a difference, and sincerely and deeply, thank you.
Well, I know what this waiting may.
Thank you. Don't
worry. I hope the waiting is sooner.
Thank you.
Just has to be. And as for you, for this, well, I thank you, but I did little enough. You're the one that came out of grief and sorrow to get this whole thing going. And I should be giving you a plaque.
Oh, no, no, not at all. it's for you, and and we're hoping that you'll remember the Children's Liver Foundation and the things that we're doing.
We'll be working with members of this staff.
That's just a
little bit. Looks better for me.
Yeah.
President, I think you know Congressman Don Sundquist.
Mr. President, good to see you, sir. Nice to see you today.
It's good to see you.
I'd like to introduce you to the delegate from 1980 and great painter, Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Anderson, thank you very much.
Well, I wanted to put you in something that I wanted to keep for me, but I thought that I didn't have the room for it, and it just spread around.
So he gave it to me, and I asked if we could present it to you, and he said we would like to do that.
I couldn't have made it for a better fellow.
Well, thank you.
You'll have it as far as I can know.
And you benefit from your artistry.
I was a delegate.
Be a lot of support.
I was one of your delegates.
You deserve even more, Mr. President.
You know, I was one of your delegates back in the...
Yes, that's right.
Here it is.
I've been told that.
I got a picture here of Nancy when she was down at the headquarters in Memphis, and thought maybe you'd like to have it.
You painted that?
I did that for the campaign, and they're still using it in different places when they have Republican functions.
Thank you very much. I won't be able to show this to her for a couple of days.
Oh, that's all right.
Out of the city, doing something.
Sure.
That she's working on.
My wife participated in that marvelous work. That's great. It's a picture of the artist for you, also.
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks very much.
Have you lost my mind?
Okay, that's good.
Thank you.
How are you? Good to see you. It's a pleasure.
Bob
Baldwin. Well, it's a pleasure to see you.
Bob's one of those who used to be a Democrat, and he was so pleased with the job you're doing, he became a Republican. So.
Well, listen, having gone that path before, because I was a Democrat for many years.
That's true.
And
that's
true. I changed because I just I felt I could no longer follow the direction leadership has taken the party.
Well, I found myself constantly voting right. I told Mrs. Holt
after she was elected the second time that she should allow me to change, and she said, no, don't do it.
You need a Democrat over there. He was so firm.
Well, you know, I went through that too, and I know what it takes. I began, my first time to it, I actively worked for candidates when I was in show business, you know, and put out fundraisers and everything. And finally, the first time that I ever voted was for Ike, but I still stayed in the party. And actually, I justified it then on the grounds that I had been one who signed a telegram urging him to run as a Democrat in 48, and no one knew what he was. So when he did run, I voted for him. But I never got around to changing it, and I was making a lot of speeches and things. But more and more, I kept being uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. And then when 60 came along, I decided to campaign on a Republican ticket. And they asked me to stay Democrat while I was doing it. But in 62, and you probably never had an experience like this, but I was, by this time, the Republicans just took me for granted. Mm-hmm. And I was speaking at a fundraiser. And a woman stood up right in the middle of the audience and asked me if I'd re-registered yet. And I said, no, but I'm going to. And she said, I'm a registrar. And she walked right down the center aisle, put the paper on the podium, and I saw
it. Called you right then and there.
But I like it on this side.
Bob's a contractor, and ABC started in my district how long ago?
I guess it's about 33 years ago. Yeah. And really appreciate what you've done for the construction industry and freeing things up so that we can go back to work. And
welcome, brothers.
Well, we certainly appreciate your taking your valuable time and
let us enjoy
this beautiful office and view a little bit.
Great pleasure.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Mr. President. Right. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thank you. This is Robin. Robin? You say hi? Where we can see, huh?
She's good looking.
And this is Jenny.
Jenny's good.
That's Donnie.
Hello.
And that's Kim.
Hi, Kim.
And you remember Linda?
Yes, hello.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
So nice of you to take time to meet our children.
Listen, appreciate that.
Let's have a family picture.
All right,
with one stranger in the midst.
Let's see. I'm going to put her over here. There. You're not going to look? You say look over here? Huh? Maybe she won't do that. Here we go. Look over there, Rob. Look out that window. Huh?
Yeah, maybe the white squirrels. We have an albino squirrel.
Do you?
Comes in there. I put the acorns on the stones there every day.
Huh. See that squirrel outside?
I saw him 15 years.
Get that finger out of your mouth. See that squirrel over there?
I was wondering if it's not going to be true. Well.
Uh-oh.
Something
for everybody. Look at that box. What's on that box? You got a press?
She fell asleep in the car and she won't.
You crash.
Well, this
here, once you get over here,
just seal.
You about the president, I'll get on the other side.
My signature. But it's also on the jar that's in the box.
Uh-oh. Oh,
the
boy.
Jar has
huh?
Our favorite. Thank you.
Well, we appreciate that.
It'll probably last a total of 5 minutes. By the time we get home in the car, they'll be gone, I'm sure.
Good.
Thank you.
Just bring it back and we'll fill it up.
Oh, don't say
great. I wonder if while we're doing that and we have the photographers, if you and I might get a picture.
All right.
I don't have one that's you and I. I have us in a reception and so on, but could we do it maybe sitting down or me sitting in a chair, you sitting in a chair or something like that?
I'll tell you what's a better picture. Let's do it at the desk.
All right. All right. You know to be Gary Hart, so you're in good shape by a pollster from Oklahoma.
Say, I'm glad.
Well, listen, thank you so much.
Well, listen.
Appreciate it.
You asked for an autograph?
I've only heard them once.
That's Kim, I think.
K-I-M.
K-I-M.
Oh, you got an autograph too?
Oh, Jenny. We're going to do that, show that to all the kids?
Show and tell.
What do you say?
Mm-hmm. Right. And
Jenny.
Jenny.
J
J-E-N-N-Y.
J-E-N-N-Y.
Boy, now that's pretty neat, huh?
Can you sign with me in the back of the book?
Oh, boy.
Done.
Thank you.
D-O-N-N-Y.
What?
D-O-N-N-Y.
Yeah. You could take this page out.
Yeah.
Well, you have a book, or would you like something else of it?
That's fine.
Huh?
He doesn't have a book.
Well, now, see, tearing it up, if you don't have a book.
Wait.
Come on. It's not my answer.
And?
Don.
Don. D-O-N-N-Y.
You sign that as good as the machines do.
Thank
well, listen,
you
thank you very much. We appreciate
well,
that.
Listen, it's a great pleasure
well,
to see you.
You're kind to take time out of a busy schedule.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Nice to see you again.
Hello, Mr. President.
Hi, how are you?
Wonderful to see you.
Well, it's good to see you.
May I present my friend Nancy DeMoss?
Hello there. Nice to see you as well.
See, this isn't the purpose of our visit, but may I take just a second to tell you that you were great in Columbus the other day. That was just a... The response you got from the audience was the best I've ever seen. He spoke from the National Association of Evangelicals and just brought the house down, of course.
Oh, thank you.
That's nothing surprising. Mr. President, the reason we wanted to come is that when you signed that year of the Bible resolution a year ago at the prayer breakfast, Mrs. DeMoss was inspired to conceive and implement a advertising campaign on television and in a number of national publications to promote a book called Power for Living, literally to encourage Bible reading. And she involved a number of your friends, Ephraim Zimbalist and Pat Boone and Chuck Colson and others. And the results of it were so phenomenal that I wanted her to have a chance to tell you something about it.
Well, I would like to hear.
We have brought you something that will tell you about it far better than I can. This is what was sent the people. And this is your copy.
Thank you.
The powerful little book. That really tells.
The extraordinary thing, Mr. President, is that.
We could use some other things. We could use that money elsewhere here.
After having spent my Christmas in the company of my parents in El Salvador, I have returned to this, my adopted country, with a great deal of anxiety concerning the fate of the country of my birth. It is fortunate that my parents live in the capital, but unfortunately I had the unpleasant experience of learning firsthand of atrocities committed by guerrillas. It happened that an informer and his family fled the Morazan province and settled outside the city of Zacatecoluca. The guerrillas found him and took him and his wife and two children to the town square. There, in front of the town people, they used their machetes on his wife and children, starting at the fingers and toes. When they finished with them, they shot the husband in the head. Needless to say, international amnesty was not to be found. I won't go on with the rest of the letter there, but...
We found all the way to space, Mr. President, and down this boat for 21 million this morning. We got it down this boat for 21 million this morning. So your phone calls are pretty good.
Well, now we got the Appropriations Committee tomorrow. But I think I've been doing at least some tentatives there, as well as one or two positives. I completed that call to Jim. Did he join me? A little work on that, see what he'll do.
President, today we're gathered to talk about...
It's a special privilege.
To at least be able to say to you that we're committed to furthering our country, both commercially as well as politically.
Alex can have the turn to do the honors here. Nice to see you, Mr. President. Megan's a little bigger this time since the last time we saw her.
Mr. President, I'm Bruce Chapman. Nice to see you. This is Kiki Vanderway. It was Father Ernie Vanderway from the New York Knicks, formerly out of California. And Kiki is donating his work tonight.
And even hometown loyalty prevents me from hoping that you are a high scorer.
Well, we're going to try tonight. See it if he could down the
there in the dark, and I told him to get going, or I'd blow his head off. I couldn't tell him to stay there, because there was no way I could then get downstairs. So, and he turned around, pointed the gun up at me, and I said, "Come on, I'm a man." So then I told her, I said, "Wait a minute," and I put on a robe and slippers and went down.
And she remembered it all the time.
I took her to the hospital. No, she did. She didn't die. But a friend told the press about it when I went to Ottawa on this trip. And they had her there. I'd never known who she was.
Oh, I'll be darned.
Never known anything. She recognized me with being forced to.
Yeah.
But anyway, so I met her and was able to tell her in front of 7,000 people that I didn't have the bullets for the
Pleased to be giving Maureen her oath of office over here in the Oval Office. She is a former English teacher, Mr. President, in both the high school and the college level. And besides that, she's a darn good attorney. So we're really pleased to have her.
As a matter of fact, Chair, I'm being pinned out of cards, so I wouldn't forget. You know, there are two ways you make remarks if you don't make notes on them. There's what you intended to say, what you said, and on the way home, what you wish you said. So I wanted to put some down, I know that, because this is an historic event. Because I was pleased to be witnessing the swearing in of the Maureen Corcoran, who is the new general counsel of the Department of Education, and this is the first woman ever appointed to be a general counsel of a cabinet department. Now, in addition to that, you've served in this administration in the office of the general counsel of the Department of Health and Human Services, special assistant to the U.S. Attorney here in Washington, and you are a former teacher, 12 years, as Ted said, now a practicing attorney, and you bring a kind of unique experience to this position because your experience in law encompassed practice in the private as well as the public field and also within the judicial system. I also know that you're more or less dedicated to the philosophy of this administration.
Oh, I absolutely am, Mr. President. Wonderful to be here.
Let's proceed in case she changes her mind.
It's that part where we say in this oath of office without any reservation or purpose of evasion. It's the test on it. And if you raise your right hand, repeat after me, I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I take this obligation freely.
I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
That I will well and faithfully.
I will well and faithfully.
Discharge the duties on which I'm about to enter.
Discharge the duties on which I'm about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations on your sworn in.
Thank
you. I'm very pleased to be here. It's a great honor to be invited to your office. I want you to know me. Thank you. Thank you, Maureen.
It's terrific.
I think so too.
So do I. All
right. Well, I want you to know that it's great to be a Midwesterner and a Californian and know I am in good company in this office.
Maureen, congratulations.
Thanks.
Pleased to have you in the administration.
Thank you.